Hello, I'm Deborah Reed, WKTV Managing Editor. We're here today on WKTV Journal Soundbites with local author Siobhan Mateen. Welcome, Siobhan.
Hi, thank you for having me, Deb. Excited to be here.
Siobhan, you have written a middle grade family adventure fantasy novel called Shayla Marsden and the Rogue Roots, and it's going to be released December 19th, just in time for Christmas. Advanced readers have given Rogue Roots high praise, saying it's an exhilarating coming-of-age extravaganza and unapologetic fantasy fiction at its finest. Can you tell those watching what inspired you to write Shayla Marsden and the Rogue Roots and why this particular story?
Sure. So again, thank you for having me, Deb. What a year, by the way. But with Shayla Marsden and the Rogue Roots, I had a vision and I wanted to write down a list of things that I wanted to accomplish. And writing a fantasy fiction novel was one of those things, and especially a fantasy fiction novel that could be easily adapted to either a TV series or a film. And so that's how Shayla Marsden came about. I was really eager to put something down. And with my curiosity and imagination and vision, the story was born.
Wonderful. And I did notice on your website that you mention themes in your novel. Can you tell us a little bit about what themes you've woven into the story?
Sure. So for sure, coming of age. Again, this is a middle grade fantasy fiction novel. So coming of age, bravery, facing challenges dead on, and how to navigate through those different things. So those were some of the things that were very important that I wanted to be sure to display throughout the story. And I think Shayla captures that. And with those themes, they very easily translate to something that could be epic on film. So I wanted to be sure that I wrote it in a way that would give a great vision and a great framework for people to see my vision and also just kind of support that vision for it to come alive on film.
Awesome. So, and I noticed you call Shayla a role model for readers of all ages. So what in your mind sets Shayla apart as a role model for people and for kids especially?
Sure. So throughout this novel, Shayla is facing some pretty epic challenges kind of early on. And so the way she navigates through just the real life and also just some of those different elements in magic, how she navigates those challenges, I think that's something to, especially for young readers, to kind of take notice of and see how she's navigating those challenges and that she's facing head on. In the story, she also faces challenges at school, and a lot of young children can definitely relate to that type of story, especially with, things like bullying and things of that nature that are kind of prevalent in school. And so the way Shayla navigates through those kind of expertly in her own way, I think that's something to be had. And I think children and readers of all age would enjoy that and also kind of, relate to that type of those type of challenges and how she overcomes it.
Wonderful. And I have noticed that a lot of middle grade and young adult novels also relate really well to adults. So I think that's great. What would you say the main message of Shayla Marsden and throughout the novel, maybe her as a character or throughout the novel, is there a main message that you're trying to convey?
Sure. So throughout this novel, basically just the readers, I want them to realize that you may have challenges coming from you at all angles, but again, the way you navigate through those challenges and the way that you face them head on, face them courageously too. And I think throughout the story, you can see that Shayla and her family expertly faces these different challenges that they're up against, and they also face them together as a family. And so I think that's very intricate, and I think that's very important throughout the story.
And on your website, you have Shayla Marsden merchandise for sale, which I thought was really cool. And because there are lots of different options for people to choose from. And you referenced the Shayla Marsden movement. So talk to us a little bit about what that means.
Sure. So the Shayla Marston movement, ultimately, the goal is to have this adapted to either a TV series or a film. And so by readers and anyone, any fan, for instance, by them supporting the movement, meaning purchasing merchandise, purchasing the book, sharing the story, that's joining the movement. And so that gets us one step closer to that goal to have this adapted to a film or a TV series.
Wonderful, and that would be very exciting.
Yes, for sure.
So once you release this book on December 19th, where can readers find it and purchase Shayla's story?
Sure. So Shayla Marston and the Rogue Roots is going to be released on the 19th. Very exciting. It'll be available via distribution. So you can check it out. It'll be at your major outlets as well as Amazon. It'll be on a Kindle format as well. So for those who enjoy a more e-format, it'll be available there as well for purchase.
Okay. And are there any upcoming fun events that you have planned as you kind of bring this out into the world for everybody to see?
Oh, yeah. So, Deb, as I mentioned, I'm really excited about 2024. I have some really great activities and events coming up for 2024. You can find us on tour. We'll be visiting some of our local schools as well as some of the museums that are in the area as well as out of state too. So we'll be kind of going on a little book tour. Really excited though for February, which is Black History Month, as well as Literacy Month in March. And so we'll be doing a lot of events during those months. So if people would like to learn more about that, they can definitely check that information out. We'll be adding more updates as they come on the website.
Okay, that is great. I love that you already have so many things lined up. That's wonderful.
Absolutely. I want to hit the ground running, Deb.
Yeah. Now, I do know that your job, everyday job, I should say, is quite different from writing. So can you kind of tell us a little bit about what you do for your everyday job, and kind of, I know you had mentioned that you had a list of things that you wanted to accomplish, and writing a book was one, but what really kind of drove this desire to do something so different from your everyday job?
Great question. So in my everyday role, I actually get to do what I like to do. I'm an HR technologist by trade. And so I get to consult with businesses across the country to help configure software that helps meet their business needs. And so that's totally different from Shayla Marston and the Rogue Roots. But I do have an interest in the fantasy fiction realm. When you mentioned the list that I wrote, I had a list of things that I wanted to accomplish. Becoming an HR technologist was one of them. Writing a book that could be easily adapted to film was another one, which Shayla Marston, the Rogue Roots, and also doing a podcast, in which I also did, was called HRIS Streamlined Podcast, where I had the awesome opportunity to connect with HR technologists across the country and just learn more about them and how they got their start. And so those were some of the most important things that I wanted to accomplish on my list that I was able to do.
That's wonderful, and that's I love your drive to really accomplish what you want to in life. That's fantastic.
Thanks, yeah, appreciate that.
So, one more question: what's next? Are you going to be? Do you have any plans to write another book? Do you have any other life adventures or checklists that you plan to check off?
For sure. So as you know, my goal, ultimate goal for Shayla Marston and the Rogue Roots is to definitely get it adapted to a film or TV series. So that's my ultimate goal in the next steps. As far as for me, just taking things, you know, as they come. I'm really excited about this project, getting it out to the world, and just, you know, being able to convey the message. And there is a book too that is going to be in the works for this series. So I'm looking forward to getting started with that. We actually have the bare bones constructed for it. So we're just waiting to get those things going, and we should have that done by the end of the year.
Great. Well, I look forward to seeing that one too. Awesome. Well, Siobhan, we've come to the end of our time today. Thank you so much for joining us on WKTV Journal Soundbites.
Thanks for having me, Deb. I greatly appreciate it. Have a great one, everyone.